any more objective than what is being rammed down your throats. The point being that any perspective is not objective. So the exercise is not to try to be more objective. The exercise is to acknowledge that objectivity as a standard is the problem. Okay, for lawyers, it is almost impossible to hold on to that idea because everything about law is hinging upon it being objective knowledge. Okay, if we do nothing else by the end of this unit, except that start wondering about is objectivity my goal, then that would be a huge achievement. Mm-hmm. So the exercise is not to make things less biased, but to challenge that there can be objective knowledge and there is biased knowledge. So what is happening in current literature is basically that the criticism that critical thinkers have of mainstream thinking of law is labeled bias. So if you have a Marxist perspective, if you have a feminist perspective, you are told that you do not have an objective understanding of law. What Davis is helping us do is realize that that is not a valid criticism because there is no possibility of objectivity, whether in law, whether in any other discipline, and not even in science. Mm-hmm. If you seriously take it on board, then it becomes possible for you to start thinking slightly differently. Now, you might turn around and say, in this unit it is all right. But if my lecturer in the next unit doesn't think like that, I'm not mad to go and parade all this information in front of them. What do I do? Haven't you created a difficulty for my life as if my life wasn't difficult enough? Now you have created that I have to at least think two ways just to survive.
So this is the feeling which I got from this class was there in the very first class of MEM. When I was new to law, but there were too many things which were coming, ideas, schools of thought, which I was totally unaware of. But after experiencing or learning a little bit law or experiencing it in the courts of law, it's just like now what I feel or the feeling right from the very first class is just like when you cage a bird in a very big room, not in so when you cage a bird not in a cage but in a room, and it doesn't have eyes, room is locked. You can fly within this area, but you don't even know that there is anything else out there. And now when you realize, when you open your eyes, you again see the same thing which is or which was there. So again the thing is we are not accepting something else because it's not allowed, kind of thing. The feeling which comes the way judges perform when you are going at bench, and you will be unbiased or you'll be following rules and things of that sort. Like it's just like everything is prefixed.
And I can do nothing about it. I accept that. And I do not, that's what I'm saying. I do not expect you from tomorrow onwards to...
I understand we are not expected to do or make great changes. But the thing is how to step ahead, even a single step. The point or the criticism always comes is what is the other option or how you are going to start.
Yeah.
Forget about option. How you are, even if I have thinking, I realize that someone or this particular thing or problem can be solved in a different manner as well, which is way way better.
Better.
But how you are going to do it? It always revolves in your mind. Anything like from here, because when we speak about higher law or natural law or something which is really good, it is so high that there is nothing in between to
There's
climb.
There's no connection between that and my reality.
Like how, and you are in a cage. Like so tough to even think about.
Alright, can I make, I understand exactly what you're saying, but I also want to make the point, and this is what Amita had said 2 days ago also, that these are ideas that we have to recognize, that we are so trained to think in a certain manner. Now that certain manner is being knocked a little bit, and it is a very uncomfortable place to be. But if they are never knocked, then you will never realize that it may be a big cage, but it is a cage all right. So the very fact that you realize, if you realize that it is a big cage, is a start. How do I start making a change? Writing a very good essay for me is a starting point. I'm not joking. I mean it, that basically thinking has to be, we have to own up. Now what you're saying is everything else remains the same. My changing my thinking doesn't help. The point is that there is huge amounts of literature in this genre out there that our legal educators do not expose us to. That is a cause of concern, should be a cause of concern. So where do we start is by finding like-minded or open-minded teachers and engaging them in a conversation. If all of you were tomorrow or after you finish your legal studies wanting to go and become legal academics, can you imagine doing law differently? Can you imagine you being a legal practitioner or a legal judge and doing law differently, slightly differently, maybe if not entirely differently? At least you wouldn't take the position that if there is a feminist argument, I have to disregard it because I'm an objective judge. That you realize that that is a valid perspective to have. There are so many incremental changes that happen, which would not happen if you are not shaken in your certainties at least a little bit. If it feels a little bit uncomfortable, no harm. So it's like just because it is uncomfortable is not a reason enough to not have to grapple with these ideas. If nothing else happens and you just think of, engage with these ideas only at the level of abstract ideas, even that is, I think, a worthwhile exercise. So just to, I'll give you a break. I think you guys have to go. Yeah? Okay. So basically then what I want you to see is that the purpose of her chapter today is to shake our confidence in that scientific method is a unbiased or a objective method of reaching the truth of anything. And then she is going to go on and say that basically when lawyers, legal thinkers use science to validate how they are thinking, they do it in a peculiarly, I can't say non-scientific method, but they do it in a very strange manner, and we need to examine that. So shall we have a 10-minute break and then start again?